The Blogs tool enables you to create a shared online diary for use in class. This tutorial shows you how to create a new blog and select settings that meet your learning objectives. Users can access the Blogs tool in several ways, through course menu links, content area links, or from the Tools area, depending on where the instructor makes the tool available. We'll access the Blogs tool from its course menu link. Click Create Blog. Type a blog name and instructions. Students see the instructions as they create their blog entries. They can respond to prompts in your instructions. Next, ensure that the blog is available to students. Optionally, you can limit the blog's availability to specific dates and times. Determine how students will participate. Course blogs allow all students to post entries and comment. Individual blogs permit each student to create entries only within their own blog, with the rest of the class reading and commenting on it. Let's select Individual to All Students and allow anonymous entries and comments. Choose whether you want users to see blog entries grouped by month or week. You can allow users to edit or delete entries, and allow them to delete comments. You can make the blog gradable by giving it a point value. Set the number of entries that trigger Needs Grading status. When grading is enabled, you can give the blog a due date. Entries made after the due date are marked late in the Grade Center and on the Needs Grading page. Lastly, you can associate a rubric with the graded blog and determine whether or not students can view it. Now, click Submit. A notice indicates that the blog was created. Right now, students can access this blog through the Blogs tool. Let's make a link in a content area for easier access. Access a content area. Point to Tools in the action bar, and select Blogs from the drop-down list. You can link to the list of existing blogs, a specific blog, or create a new blog. Let's link to the new blog we created. Click Next. These settings are for the link that appears in the content area, not for the blog itself. For example, you could make the link unavailable here, but students could still access the blog from the Blogs tool. Now, click Submit. A link to the new blog is now available to students in this content area. When users view the blog, they can see the blog type, number of entries, and comments and instructions. Users are notified about new blog entries in My Blackboard's Posts page. Let's review. First, access the Blogs tool. Then, create a new blog and set blog options. Additionally, you can create a link to the blog in a content area.